So let's look at our exceptions with aerobic quiz solution. At the point where this divide has an exception, this is what we had. When we go to the exception handler for this divide, what should be happening is that the instructions before it have finished and the instructions after it have not finished as far as the programmer is concerned. So what we need to really do, because programmer really sees only what has committed here, is the fact that this is done and this is done needs to be undone. So basically, this instruction is flushed from the pipeline. It behaves as if it was not executed at all. This instruction and this instruction as well. So pretty much what we do is when we have an exception such as divide by zero, the correct state of the processor should be right before this instruction if we were doing these instructions one at a time. So what we do is we roll back the execution of all these instructions. How do we do that? Well, we have already committed this instruction before. It has to stay committed. We cannot uncommit instructions. This instruction has been executed and this one has been done. What we do is we wait for them to commit. So what's going to happen is this instruction will eventually commit once it's done executing, and then this one was already done, so it can very quickly commit afterwards. Now we reach the point where the divide carries this exception condition into the commit with it. So when we try to commit the divide, we realize we cannot do that. And that's the point at which we stop committing, flush everything that follows the divide from the pipeline. So these instructions now become unexecuted, meaning we haven't even fetched them as far as the programmer is concerned. And this is the point at which we jump to the exception handler. So pretty much at the point where we call any exception handler, what you have is some instructions have committed. Some of them haven't been even fetched. They have been actually fetched, but we have discarded them. So they behave like they haven't been fetched. And that's the point where the control is transferred to the exception handler instead of this way. So it acts very much like a branch misprediction, except that it happens on an exception.